Yeah, so I think it's a bright forecast. Mm-hmm. So fire it away.
All right, let's look at 2015. What's it going to be like?
Well, normally in feng shui, like what we all say, we always refer to a chart. It's like a roadmap. Mm-hmm. We just don't simply pluck it from the sky and do the forecast. So we do an analysis, and then luckily the 2015 forecast suggests that the chart has the elements, the five elements present. Unlike last year, 2014, we are lacking the elements of two elements.
Okay.
So at least in 2015, we have the five elements. Right. So the presence of the wood, the earth, the water, the metal, the fire are all present.
And that means what?
That means it's a very quite balanced chart. Mm-hmm. Another significant presence of the chart is that it has the presence of the so-called secret friends. Remember, we have the so-called allies and friends.
Right.
So the four pillars, meaning that the time, the hour, the day, the month, and the year, has the so-called allies and friends.
Mm-hmm.
So it is quite unusual to have the five elements present, mm-hmm. and even the allies and friends present. So it is a positive year. Another thing that we could look forward to is, although quick fighting or misunderstanding would arise,
mm-hmm.
people would tend to be more conciliatory. They'll be more, they'll opt for reconciliation.
Right. Mm-hmm.
I think this would be a year that I could say we can all agree to disagree.
So was last year considered generally a bad year, if this year is considered positive, or just to kind of gauge?
Yes, yes. Okay. I mean, I think when we were announcing the forecast for 2013, we were very definite to say that because it's the year of the horse, the attitude of the horse, you know, they kick, it's the year when one would want to outdo one another.
Mm-hmm.
The sheep, if you look at it, is the attitude as well, it's meek and mild. It's milder than the horse,
right.
Yeah? We also reckon that, like what I said on our forecast, the international disagreement would appear, even within our homes or within the country, but people will tend to go more for to reconcile.
Right.
It's really like make love, not a war.
Mm-hmm. All right, what everyone's waiting for, who's going to be lucky this year?
Okay, so do you want me to go through the old 12 animal signs?
Yes,
or
you want that.
Okay. Do we have the time? Yeah, so maybe I think, like what I said, remember that these are just guidance. In terms of feng shui, we have to understand that we have to look at three dimensions. First is the space dimensions. This is the place where we live in, you know, like the homes, the offices. And then second is the time. That's why we keep updating. That's why thank you so much for inviting me again to be here to give forecasts, like where are the energies moving around,
right.
And just be guided with that. And then, you know, to some hardcore feng shui followers, they use the spiritual feng shui dimension.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, that's not for today. So we'll do the first two muna. So the first is actually, if you look at the chart, it's very easy. It's also, Pinky is holding that as well.
And there's an app now for that.
Yes, and the app is coming up soon.
Right.
It's coming up soon on Apple Store. Yes.
Okay.
So if you notice, it's just really very straightforward. The reds are the bads and the greens are the goods.
Okay.
Okay. So it's very easy just to see that if we start with the rat, so the rat-born people has the wealth star for the year.
Mm-hmm.
So money. And remember, it only happens every once in every 9 years.
Right.
So mga rat, panahon nyo na, kumita ng malaking pera. So don't waste the time. Go and work hard
it's
for it.
The rat race.
The rat race, okay. Now, the ox and the tiger has the so-called number six, or the heaven's luck.
Okay.
So this is like the luck for maybe windfall luck, something that is unexpected. Maybe lipamana.
Right.
But between the tiger and the ox is a bit obstructed because of it's the year of the sheep.
Mm-hmm.
So contra, they are enemies.
Mm.
So tiger would do better than the ox.
Mm.
Then next we have the rabbit. The rabbit has the so-called victory star number one.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're looking forward for something to begin with, business or anything, it's a good time for you to really start. And then we also have the so-called dragon and snake. The dragon and snake, although they have the so-called reducing star of illness, they actually has a very special chart that is saying that they are seated on a golden deity star. So for example, snake-born people, it appears that
that's you
that whatever you venture into, you have like a Midas touch, like you can turn into gold. Mm-hmm. Oh, diba? So it's a golden deity that resides on your chart now. So that is why, if you notice, some people just really makes lucky. You know, some people, they just like, wow, what is happening? Why is your luck so lucky? So knowing this ahead of time can really help you out. Mm-hmm. So that's for the dragon and the snake. And then, again, like what I said, we have Bangontra, we have cures and enhancers on how to prevent the illness. We have the... So we finished the dragon, the snake, we have the horse. The horse will have the so-called rubbery star. So something that is yours or may have been taken away. Mm-hmm. So if I were you, rather than losing money, you invest into something. Baka panahon na natin bumili ka ng panibagong, maybe you want to buy something special. Mm-hmm. Like you better. What? I don't know, maybe more properties if you have the money. Rather than losing it away, invest it now or maybe donate to charity.
How will they lose it? I mean, will they get robbed? You know, what is...
Robbery would mean that, say you signed a contract for an X amount of money, but then it ended up, you know,
mga pautan,
shortcut.
Probably.
Pautan is you are sure not to be paid off.
So not necessarily like you invest and the investment loses. It's more like
it's
so
the
you're
same.
Kind of
like you know, you started in a very good discussion that things are gonna, you know, and then at the end it didn't just work out the way you agreed it at the beginning. So something that maybe rub away from you. So in effect, better invest or give it to charity, or if you can, then you know, invest it in a very solid.
Or give it to your daughter.
So that's the horse, and then the sheep and the monkey has the so-called prosperity star. So anything that you do can be sort of multiplied 9 times. So which is really, really super awesome. So sheep and monkey, and then again, this is generic, and then we'll discuss later for some other things. Then we have the rooster. The rooster, unfortunately, has the so-called misfortune star for the year. If this was with the directions of the dog it bore last year, it now has flew in to the rooster. So take
it easy. Happened things last year.
Hindi,
it bore.
Oh, and you too,
yeah.
Oh, the three of us.
Yeah. Finally, we get a break.
I know.
do we agree?
How was it? The health
Do we agree that it was, health was really bad
for him? It wasn't great.
I mean, he's healthy and he's, you know, very active.
No, but it wasn't great. It wasn't great.
Because so you can say it was one of your bad health years.
Sure, I've been healthier for sure.
So you know, when we know these things, it's just better to be guided ahead of time. So the rooster, it's now the misfortune star flew into the rooster, and now we have the dog and the boar.
What's the dog and the boar?
The dog and the boar, as you can see, has the Roman star number 4. So if you want to start a relationship, get married, if you are single and raring.
There are 2 single ladies here.
Yeah. My left and right. If you're raring to you know, go ahead. this is
a good year.
Yeah, the universe permits you to do that.
Okay, but apart from that,
yeah.
Let's move on to anyway.
So the one you have for the dog and the boar. Is there anything else?
Yeah. Money. Well, it's like this. Career is actually looking bright. In fact, for the Roman slack, you can also, if you guys are thinking of expanding your network, socializing. In fact, this is a very good year for networking. Mm-hmm. Networking is.
Akala ko not.
Networking luck is very very good for the year. At the same time, if you want to do further studies, specialize into something, very good. Yes.
But is there a trade-off? I mean, like for people who are born under the sign of the snake. I mean, you were saying EJ, you know, would seem to have a Midas touch, but he has to watch his health this year. You know?
Yes.
Is there sort of a trade-off?
But it's true, isn't it? Because, you know, the more you get so active, you know, you get loses of sleep, you don't have time because you want to take on everything, and then, you know, it's going to go back to yourself.
Right.
So it's really, it's up to you. The star says that it's up to you to say, hey, I'm only going to work 12 hours a day instead of 24 hours.
But I mean,
is there a trade-off for the dog and
for the dog? Yeah, for the dog. It seems like it's all good news so far. Is there
just fine if there's no
news for the dog and the selfish?
Actually, it's like this.
Forget him.
In the 12 months, this is the generic forecast. There's also one thing that you have to understand, that in the 12 months of the year, we also have the lucky stars each month as well.
So your highs and those in this
So yeah, that is why you have to get your sides, your book.
Ooh,
it
there
says there. So we'll set over one for
All
you,
right.
of course.
Pa-pa-set-up na lang.
So and then what you can do as well is you can get the almanac, mm-hmm. the planner, which is soon gonna be available on our app.
App as well.
Yes. Where you can
What's
just
your
actually,
sign?
I'm a monkey.
You're a monkey, all right.
Yes.
It looks like you're networking and whatnot. It's also very good this year. Look at that.
But we started this last year. Mm-hmm. So people when they would like to sort of like sign contracts,
right.
move house mm-hmm. and
Look
everything.
For a good time to
they
do that.
They keep texting me even if you know, I have moved to England 5 years ago. Mm-hmm. So I'm like a walking diary for them. So
now right. you said, you know what, I'm just gonna put it all for you.
Yeah,
guys.
So this one, yeah, so people has two options. They can either get the hard copy of the planner or they can actually download the app. So again, these are guidance mm-hmm. and then please do something about your home.
Right.
So if we say that the north has the wealth star for the year, then activate it with water element, you know, active, make it. If it's your entrance of the home, then do it right.
Mm-hmm.
So really in terms of looking at the goods and the bad sectors of the house, you can now determine which sectors of the house needs enhancing mm-hmm. or needs suppressing.
Right.
This is the reason why at the world of feng shui, we have cures and we have enhancers. Mm-hmm. In Friga naman, what we did when I moved to England is I went back to school. I went to the London College of Fashion.
Mm-hmm.
And my professors from the are also professors from the College of St. Martin's and everything.
Right.
So what they did is they put together my forecast with a trend forecast as well.
Okay.
So, for example, for our spring-summer 2015 collection, my fabric designer in London, we created, they incorporated my forecast. So this is like the special mantra. And then the birds, because I want people to, you know, birds, they fly out, they get opportunities for mm-hmm. you. And around here are actually the eight auspicious symbol.
Very cool.
Yeah.
So would you call this a
affirmation scarf?
Okay.
Because Pinky, if you don't mind
so it's
reading
a charm
it.
Of sorts?
Okay. Yes, what does it say?
I'm cool, I'm gorgeous, I'm healthy, I'm loving, I'm amazing, I'm fabulous. So it's all positive.
Yes.
Mantras.
I think I'm in need of this scarf.
Yes, you can have it.
There you go.
Oh, you let the formula.
Okay, now, there you go, part. See how your luck is already changing?
No, the man also has one. So you can use this because the demands that they've been looking for us, especially mm-hmm. the men executives, you can put in as your pocket square,
right.
you know, or a hanky. Mm. And a very good thing, you know, that you can carry as well around.
Oh, okay. So it's the same sort of message.
Yes.
In a more masculine
package.
Yes. Oh, this is great.
In general, Marites.
Look at how the boards
is,
are just...
which is
we
the
are
most,
just,
which
yeah.
is the luckiest?
I would say it's the snake.
The snake is the luckiest.
Because, you know...
That's why she's not giving you anything.
Okay,
because you're lucky.
So you're lucky now.
You will have. The dragon and the snake, because they sit on the so-called positive stars left and right.
Mm-hmm.
So, go.
Go.
Make it happen.
All right.
And the...
And the next 3 years, by the way, before I finish, mm-hmm. the next 3 years, if you set it right this time, it's the ascending order.
Wow!
So better and better and better.
Beautiful.
Well, because I want, I think people are also interested. Sort of, I mean, we've talked about. You know, sort of a general outlook. You know, what about particular areas like you mentioned? Oftentimes, people like to consult feng shui when it comes to real estate, when it comes to signing a deal, politics even. Are there sort of, you know, key periods maybe in this year that need a little bit more attention or perhaps are a little more, are better times to do contracts,
yes.
buy a home? Or that's
actually, in terms of, because you mentioned about politics, I would say because election is coming,
yeah.
so if people are thinking of doing alliances or you know, I don't know, I am never familiar with the political party system mm-hmm. in the country, I'm sorry, but if they have to think about it now to do some alliances, talk about it, mm-hmm. you know, get on the, you know, so it will not get in the way at the tail end of the year,
mm-hmm.
better to start and begin the talk now.
Right.
And then always put in mind that the arguments will be there, the jealousy, the politicking will be around. But at the end of the day, everyone will have to really agree that at some point they have to disagree over something
mm-hmm.
to form a better team or a better party, for example. So that's on the political side. Mm-hmm. So agree to disagree and move on.
You also have a forecast for the president, right?
The rat-born people, like the president, has the so-called peach blossom luck. Mm-hmm. So which is the peach blossom luck, and then luckily the love department.
Oh wow!
This is in addition to the dog and the boar could be active. So baka hindi na siya Coke Zero, Coke Light na. another thing is that if the president's luck is lucky in a way of the World Star number 8, maybe we would give him more opportunity to travel and get investment for the country. You know what I mean? You have to ride on the lap of a person. Mm-hmm. The wood element, though, which is very dominant for the year, is a bit of unfavorable elements for him. Not too much. So maybe he will still be facing challenge of, you know, people will be doubting some of his decisions. But these are pretty minor. But again, I would say let's ride on the prosperity lap and maybe he can get more investments in the country, and he's doing so well.
One more, the vice president.
The vice president is actually born in the year of the horse. Sheep is actually the secret friend of the horse. Okay. So if you know, you know, you have the bangle, this is actually the year of the horse. We have the sheep born people. Mm-mm. Yeah. The secret friend. Mm. the sheep actually could also look forward for a positive year in terms of alliances. What he would need is like somebody, a very noble man, like a very strong person to really back him up. But I would say challenges in terms of politicking or whatever it is he's facing may still continue. Mm-hmm. So again, if there's something that they could thresh out ahead of time, it is better to resolve it this early.
Oh, we can also ask about natural calamities this year.
Natural calamities, because this is the year of the wood sheep. So sheep is naturally an earth element, and the element of the year is wood. So there's a controlling effect. So there's going to be movement of the earth. So naturally, we would say that in terms of natural disasters, landslides, earthquakes, it could possibly happen. Again, I always say this to everybody, that there's never going to be a year that we are going to be spared by it. Right. There will always be.
Right. So better be prepared.
So you seem to be talking more about things related to the earth. Are we going to see less of the water element, maybe? The element of water, floods, and rain?
Yes, I think it's really more on the earth movement, like landslides or something from there. But it's still difficult to quantify, because at the end of the water below there is there's a swelling.
Right. So. You know, there's good luck and there's bad luck, but the great thing is that there's all sorts of things you can have to enhance or help suppress.
So you have the allies and friends, like for example, the rat, the dragon, and the monkey. This actually gives you the idea that, you know, these are like money around there, and it tells you that, you know, the dragons benefit from the craftiness of the monkey and the astuces of the rat. The monkeys learn from the enthusiasm of the dragons and the imagination of the rat. So it goes with the different allies and friends out here.
Okay. They're great colors. I just want to sneak in one last thing.
Sure.
When it comes to the entertainment industry, last year it was really kind of marked by a lot of showbiz weddings. Is that kind of same thing that's going to happen this year? What is it that's going to really mark the entertainment industry?
The entertainment industry is that it's very active, but the competition is very high. Mm-hmm. It is very high. But creation of something like, in terms of what we need, is something that somebody could create. Maybe a new, I don't know if you've been watching Scandal, for example, in the U.S. If we talk about the local industry, something like that. But I believe we have good hit series locally as well, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. So more like that. More
or to
entertainment
have
to have,
maybe.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, and you still have some talk, right? Coming up?
Yes. I'll be in fact this Saturday, and Sunday I'll be in Japan.
Okay. Tokyo.
I'll be in Tokyo. In fact, I'll be with the team for Home Sweetie Home.
Okay.
Oh. Yeah. So I'll be the guest there as well, and then I'll be in London, Norway, Sweden, Denmark, and several parts of the U.S. They can follow me on Twitter or Facebook or Instagram.
You're everywhere.
Marites, thank you so much, and Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year.
Thank you.